Hello guys, Henry here and welcome back to a new video. You must be seeing a lot of laptop reviews because yes, we are getting into laptop reviews. If you have any suggestions for the laptops that you want us to review, do let us know, or if you want us to add any benchmark test or any other testing that we are not doing currently in our reviews, do let us know about that in the comment section box below. We'll be more than glad to add those. This is the HP Omen 15 inch laptop. It weighs at about 2.35 kgs, which is considerably low for a 15 inch laptop. Not just that, when it comes to looks, it has sharp edges, which I personally liked because I liked how the laptop looked. A small mirror-like material in the front with Omen branding. Keyboard has backlighting, but it is only white. It cannot be changed to any other color because it's only white. I mean, obviously, it has 1.2 millimeter of key travel. And when it comes to typing experience, I enjoyed typing on this keyboard. It was not as deep as a 15, like 1.5 millimeters, but not bad by any standards. Gaming on this keyboard with WASD keys will be really good, and you can feel that you are pressing a key, unlike some of the MacBooks that we have. And when it comes to trackpad, Omen 15 comes with a slightly larger trackpad as compared to Turf A15 or let's say Legion 5i, which are also present in the similar price point. And the trackpad is something which was very responsive. It was no issues with the trackpad basically. I did not talk about the specifications. 4800H processor with 8GB of RAM, 1650 Ti graphic card, and that's little bit odd because when it comes to 4800H processor, I would any day recommend you to go or bump up to 16GB of RAM. Now this laptop has 8GB of RAM and can be upgraded to 16GB of RAM by adding extra 8GB of RAM, which will cost you about, well, let's say 5,000 to 6,000 rupees, and I would any day recommend you to do that. Not any day, I would highly recommend you to do that if you are going to do content creation or even if you are just going to play games. Having 16GB of RAM is must in my opinion when you are combining it with 4800H. As the laptop comes with 1650 Ti and not 1660 Ti. The laptop is priced at about 85,000 rupees. And at this price point, like 85 to 90,000 rupees, you can get few laptops with 1660 Ti graphic card as well. Now, are they better in gaming? Obviously, 1660 Ti is better than 1650 Ti. So if your sole purpose is just to do gaming, this laptop will get the job done, obviously. But I would any day recommend you to go to that 1660 Ti graphic card, which will perform better in gaming. But if you are a content creator for whom Premiere Pro or Photoshop is more important, than 4800H graphic card coupled with 1650 Ti at this price point will perform better instead of getting a 4700H with 1660 Ti, let's say, because CPU is more important when it comes to editing apps like Premiere Pro in my opinion. Now let's talk about the benchmark. The RDR2 average FPS with high settings was limited to 38 FPS only, which is not bad. If you want to get 60 FPS, then you will obviously lower the setting to medium or low and some other tweaks that you can do to get 60 FPS on this laptop. GTA 5 with high settings was able to reach average FPS of 124. Battlefield 5 with high settings was able to reach at 41.8 FPS. Rise of the Tomb Raider was able to cross 60 FPS very easily. Far Cry 5 with high setting once again was able to cross 60 FPS. All these benchmarks were done at 1080p setting only. Now, can the laptop perform better? Now, currently, the laptop is in single channel memory. And you have, I say it always, dual channel memory is always better. If you are building a PC and you are getting only 8GB of RAM and you are never going to upgrade to 16GB, get 2 4GB RAM stick. If you are going to build a PC with 16GB of RAM, get 2 RAM sticks so that you can use that dual channel memory and get better speeds. And with HP Omen 15, that's something which is happening. As this one doesn't have dual channel memory, it comes with only single channel memory, the FPS is slightly lower. If you, as soon as you get 16GB of RAM and utilize that dual channel memory, the FPS will increase by 10-15 FPS as well in some games, because dual channel memory really plays a huge role in my opinion. Now let's talk about the laptop itself. The laptop can go to 180 degrees like this. Now I'll just keep the laptop like this and we'll talk about the display. This is a 60Hz refresh rate display only, no 144Hz, no 120Hz. HP Omen 15 has variants with 120Hz refresh rate, a higher refresh rate basically. This one had 60Hz only, but it comes with 1080p IPS panel and the viewing angles on this laptop was really good. The display is much better as compared to how tough A15 was. I enjoyed watching content on this laptop, plus editing videos or doing slight color correction on the laptop will be a good choice in my opinion. As I said earlier, the laptop can go to 180 FPS, not 180 when you do a lot of gaming benchmarks, everything is about FPS. The laptop can go to 180 degrees, But we found that when we were using the laptop in real life, obviously you're not going to stay stable. When it's on your lap, you're going to move just a little bit. Then this display was going down automatically and it goes to 180 degrees flat. And if you keep it to this, about this angle, then it doesn't go down automatically. This is something which we felt like should have been fixed by HP, because the hinge is not that strong and should have been strong at extreme angles to hold the display like this. Now let's talk about the speakers. Once again, pretty strong speakers, not as loud as Tough A15. I'm going to mention Tough A15 a lot because I have already reviewed it. The link will be present in the I button over here. Do watch that video as well, because that's another laptop which comes with 4800H and 1660 Ti processor and will cost you about 95,000 rupees, 10,000 rupees more than this one. The speakers are good. Quality is good. Loudness, it could have been slightly louder, but I'm not going to complain about that. Now, when it comes to temperatures, the laptop did not become as hot as Tough A15. The Tough A15 crosses 90 degrees at times, as I said in my video. The laptop was considerably cooler, but it does become toasty with gaming laptops. That always going to happen. I have not seen a gaming laptop not reaching 80 or 85 degrees Celsius, staying at just 70 degrees Celsius. That laptop will be a dream laptop in my opinion, which I will recommend to everyone. When gaming laptop will not reach 70 degrees Celsius even after playing RDR2. Now this is the front facing camera sample from the HP Omen 15, and this is how the footage looks. It's not the great 720p footage, 720p basic camera. Basically, it is good enough for Zoom sessions and meetings. I guess that's the maximum I can say about the laptop. Not much. When the camera is turned on, you get a small light in the front, which is always a good thing, so that you know whenever the camera is being used. That's it for the front facing camera.
When it comes to ports, we have a charging port with LED indicator. Then we have a LAN port, which is supposed to look like this, but looks like this because I broke it when I was trying to insert a LAN cable. It came out. I did not use too much force. It's not my mistake. So if you're planning to buy the HP Omen 15, this particular variant, do take a note of that. We also have USB-A port, HDMI port, headphone jack port, and a card reader. That was surprising for me because I tested about 4 or 5 laptops in past couple of months and none of them had a card reader. That's always a good thing to see for a YouTube creator like me, who can just take out the card reader from the camera, put it inside the laptop and start copying. I do not have to worry about carrying an extra adapter. On the right side, we have the USB type C port, which can be used for charging, and a display port. We have 2 more USB A ports at the end, and in between we have a vent, which is surprising because if you put something over here and then the cable will become warm because it's after the vent. So that's something to take a note of. When it comes to heating, does it overheat? Not really. It performed, I would say, after using Tough A15, you will find almost all the laptops cooler because Tough A15 becomes so warm. And I guess that's pretty much it for the review of HP Omen 15. If you still have any more doubts, sessions or queries regarding this laptop, do let me know about that in the comment section box below. If you enjoyed this video, give this video a thumbs up. If you have any suggestions, queries regarding this laptop or this video or future laptop videos, do let us know about that in the comment section box below. We'll be more than glad to incorporate those changes in our videos. So yeah, thank you guys. Thank you for watching.